Our state has witnessed one of the most violent spring weather seasons in 30 years with tornadoes, floodings, and now it's hurricane season. For some, it's been scary. For others, fascinating. Arthur Mondale has more on a camp that is helping triad teens make sense of it all. Arthur?
Well, Kim, I can't tell you what a pleasure it was to hear about the storm and surviving it from our younger viewers. But here at A&T State University, this camp in Earth and Atmospheric is about teaching these teens not to fear the storm, but to survive the storm, in hopes they'll take a career that will take them straight to the heart of it. I want you to watch this.
Climate change is the idea that there can be more extremes.
They survived the storms of spring 2011.
It was pretty scary.
Scary, but interesting. So they decided to learn about them.
I'm interested in learning how these storms start and like where they most hit and like how they form and just going deep down into like how they like work.
All the right weather conditions coming together.
Our recent tornadic outbreak is the result of the unique circumstances at that moment in the atmosphere. There was enough instability and there was enough shear in the atmosphere.
They've happened before and they'll happen again. A&T's Earth and Atmosphere Camp offers teens hands-on weather forecasting, weather data collection, climate change, and wind patterns. Everything beyond just surviving the next big storm. Students realize in the universe, our homes are just as fragile as a few pieces of cardboard and duct tape. Seismology 101 puts it all into perspective.
Our structures are limited resources. This is part of the reason why a disaster that happens some places can be much more devastating than others. Haiti was more devastated by their earthquake than Japan was, due to, in large part, building materials.
But one overactive season leaves plenty of unknowns for another.
When you have weaker winds at upper levels, it doesn't tear the storms apart.
One thing that's not uncertain is these students are learning all the components of science, technology, math, and engineering. New storms will no doubt keep them interested.
It's a goal here, and more kids are losing interest in that. And more foreigners, for example, China is producing 40% more engineers and scientists than we do.
A grim career forecast for today in regards to the future, not if teens like Chloe Nicholson can help it.
Well, it's making me more interested because I want to be a meteorologist, and so it's just making me more interested in everything I need to know.
Good job, Chloe. By the way, today these teens will learn Meteorology 101 from the National Weather Service out of Raleigh. And Kim, if my newscasting is correct, that means Lainey, Austin, Michelle, and Brian, they got some stiff competition coming up in the next few years. That's the latest. Back to you.
It sounds like it. All right. Thank you, Arthur. Did you go through any classes like that when you were a kid?
You know, not when I was young, no. But that sounds fascinating. I'll have to get up with Arthur about it because I think the kids can learn so much.
Oh, I bet.
You know, and hands-on, really neat things there.